All right, Brent Porcia at topvelocity.net. We got a pitch analysis here, Harrison, going to pair him up with Kohei Downing. Take them both into their leg lifts. You can see Harrison's in a little bit more balanced position. Kohei's keeping the hips inside the drive leg. That just gets him in a better position to more quickly start to build momentum out of leg lift as he falls forward and down at the same rate. Okay, so this is just before his leg drive. Let's take Harrison to that same position. And he really turns and pushes the glute out hard, and the force vector gets linear. So these force vectors are coming down into a linear position, but a lot more of a lean back here than with Harrison, which can become an issue because you put the hip into a, you know, you kind of push it to end of range into full abduction. And you really want the hip more in flexion, because it's going to go from flexion to extension if we're going to fully drive and extend the legs into hip rotation. So if we go too far back into abduction, then we lose the ability to hinge and get out of the hip. It works against that, and you get the leg wanting to collapse. So if we move forward, we can see Harrison is driving from that position, but he's also driving with not much rotation. And that's the other challenge, is if you can get the drive off in that position and you're not in a hip hinge, then your hip's not going to want to come out of that hinge into extension into the drive. So you can see Kohei here, as he goes into drive, the femur wants to quickly rotate. That means that hip is starting to extend to get that femur rotation going. So when you're not getting a lot of femur rotation in your drives, it's because your hip is staying in counter rotation. And a lot of times, like you said, if you lean too far back into abduction, then you lock up that hip. And then this is what happens. You hit front foot strike, and there really isn't much hip rotation. You see Kohei hit front foot strike here, and his hips are almost completely open. Just look at the back foot, a sideways foot, and almost on the top of his toes here. Okay, I mean, everything else almost looks identical. It's just we don't have the hip drive here, more than likely because Harrison leaned too far back out of his leg lift. So from here, waiting for the hips to still come around, and that's when the hips come around. If you watch Kohei, the hips come around right here, and he's still well separated. So that means he's going to transfer more energy up and take a lot of that linear energy forward. You can see here with Harrison that trunk doesn't go forward. So the arm doesn't even lay back. So the transfer of energy up the body here isn't really happening well because the hips and shoulders are coming together because the hips relate. So everything finishes very quick and early, doesn't continue to load and sequence well up the body. Okay, and you see Kohei doing that very well, even getting his front leg to drive and extend into the movement. Okay, so I would believe just working on getting into this better loaded position that Kyohi's doing really well here, really work on feeling in your hip hinge of your drive hip, feel as you extend lower leg that the hip wants to extend out of that hinge, out of flexion. And then you can see all this femur rotation. You see all this femur rotation occurring here. We're not getting that here with Harrison because that hip is not hinging and extending out of the loaded position. So that would be, I think, a big, big piece to work on with Harrison. And then also, too, you know, like we do with our approach, we kind of work backwards. Really get better at hip-to-shoulder separation, really feeling the hips opening and driving the trunk forward and powering the trunk from front foot strike forward, and then you kind of work backwards, and then you can start to work on all the stuff out of leg lift and loading your back leg.